Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has guided us to Islam and has blessed us with more blessings than we can count. As Allah says in the Quran, وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. He has immersed you in His blessings. Some of them are apparent and you recognize, and some of them you don't even recognize and are hidden. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَآتَاكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ. He has given you everything that you asked. And as Allah says in the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you were to try to count the blessings Allah has given you, you would not be able to finish the list. If you were to try to count and enumerate the blessings, you would not be able to finish that list. And the biggest blessing and the greatest blessing that Allah has given us, compared to which all other blessings pale in comparison, the biggest blessing that Allah has given us is the blessing of Islam. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li hadha wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. All praise is due to Allah who has guided us to this, and were it not for Him, we would not be guided to this. Subhanallah, brothers and sisters, how fortunate we are to be sitting here today in this masjid. How blessed we are. And it was not from my doing or yours. How many people are on earth tonight and they have no clue of the possible blessing and sanctity of this night? How many are oblivious, heedless? How many are going about their routine as if this is not the month of Ramadan, as if tonight is not one of the potential nights of Qadr? And here we are, me and you, throughout any power of mine, I didn't will myself to be a Muslim. I did not choose, Allah chose this for me. And Allah blessed and Allah guided. And so out of this whole globe and world, Alhamdulillah, Allah guided me and you to Islam. And not only guided to Islam, but Allah blessed to be amongst those who at least are trying. I'm not perfect, you're not perfect. There's no such thing as holy saints in our religion. Every saint is a sinner in disguise. Every saint is a sinner in disguise. You just don't know his sins. And every sinner is a potential saint. We don't believe in some holy figures. I am sinful. You are sinful. And we are all struggling with our sins. But here we are in this masjid wanting to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, desiring to achieve Allah's mercy. And in that desire and in that effort is our salvation. O Muslim, realize Allah did not intend for perfection to be amongst us. If He wanted perfection, the angels sufficed. The angels do not disobey Allah. The angels do not ever disobey a command. When Allah says do, they do. There's no free will amongst them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still chose to create us. Even the angels were wondering, why would you create this new species, O Allah? Here we are. وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. Here we are glorifying you. Here we are praising you. Even the angels, in their limited minds, they were thinking, what is the purpose of this creation when they are not going to compete with us? You're going to create a creation that's going to do evil. They're going to sin. They're going to follow their desires. They're going to cause mayhem, wreak havoc on this earth. أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءُ. You're going to create this new creation that is going to wreak so much havoc. And here we are. There's no civil war amongst us, Ya Allah. There's no evil amongst us. There's no drunkards amongst us. There's no people guilty of fornication amongst us. There's no drug addicts amongst us. Why would you create this new creation in which the whole world is going to be full of that pain and suffering that we don't have amongst us? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun. You're going to have to trust me. I have wisdoms you don't understand. I know what you do not know. Still to this day, we are struggling to understand some of those wisdoms because in the end of the day, the actual wisdoms are known only to Allah. But our scholars mention and comment. Our scholars mention and comment, and some of these wisdoms are found in the prophetic traditions. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith in Sahih Muslim, لَوْلَا أَن تُذْنِبُوا. If you were to stop committing sins, لَأَذْهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ. Allah would have gotten rid of you. I'm not mistranslating the hadith. This is exactly what the hadith says. If you were to become perfect, if you were to become angels, because the angels don't commit sins, لَوْلَا أَن تُذْنِبُوا. Were it not for the fact that you are committing sins, if you stop committing sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have eliminated your existence. And He would have brought بِخَلْقٍ آخر. He would have created a new creation. يُذْنِبُونَ. They are committing sins. Pause here. This hadith is one of the most explicit hadith about the rationale and the wisdom of our existence. This hadith is explicitly demarcating one of the reasons why Allah created us. I haven't finished the hadith, don't worry. Don't stop right there. Allah does not love sin. Allah does not love evil. Allah does not love oppression. وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَسَادِ وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ. Allah does not love evil. So then why are we being told that if you stopped committing sins, if you as a creation became sinless, Allah has no need for you? That's literally what the hadith is saying. Allah has no need for you. Then if that were to happen, Allah would have gotten rid of you. And Allah would have created a new creation, a creation that is faulty like me and you. It has leaks like me and you. It has mistakes like me and you. It commits sins like me and you. Why? Why? Because the hadith goes on. They would commit sins. And then they would turn to Allah in istighfar and tawbah. And then they would turn to Allah and ask for forgiveness. And so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could forgive them. You see, Ibn al-Qayyim mentions one of the wisdoms of creating a fallible creation like us. One of the wisdoms of creating mortals like us. The angels don't die like we die. The same angel lives. There's no procreation. The same angel, the one that Allah created, will be living forever and ever. We are a different creation. We come, we die, we go, and then there's an akhirah, and there's heaven and hell, and then there's judgment. And in our finite lives, no one can attain perfection. We can't compete with the angels. But here's the point. Allah did not create us to compete with the angels. That's not our job and function. That's not our reason for being here. So then what is our reason for being here? Ibn Qayyim mentions, one of the wisdoms for the creation of mankind is that Allah wanted to manifest His forgiving nature. He wanted to manifest that He is Ghafoor, and He is Ghaffar, and He is Rahman, and He is Rahim, and He is Tawwab. He wanted to manifest that He forgives the one who comes to Him for forgiveness. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَعْفُو عَنِ السَّيِّئَاتِ. And that wisdom cannot be manifested with the angels. That set of divine attributes, that side of the divine nature, cannot be demonstrated in front of the angels. The angels don't ask for forgiveness the way we do. The angels don't come penitent and repentance. The angels don't say, Ya Allah, I really committed a major sin, I need your forgiveness. The angels are perfect. And if they do istighfar, it is because they are not worshipping as much as they feel Allah is deserving to be worshipped. Not because they fell into a mistake, because the angels also do tasbih and tahmid. But the angels don't commit sins. So Ibn al-Qayyim says, in order to manifest Allah's forgiving nature, He created us. And this leads us to one of the most important chapters of Islamic spirituality. One of the most important principles of tazkiyatun nafs. We cannot attain perfection. That's not going to happen. But Allah is not asking for perfection. Allah is asking for us to strive to be better. Allah wants to see in us the resolve, the himmah, to turn to Him and to want to be closer to Him. Allah wants the tawbah and Allah wants the turning back to Him, because that's what tawbah is. And in the process, if we fall, and if we fall short, and if we fail, that is not a failure in the eyes of Allah, because perfection can never be achieved. So what is failure? Failure is to not even attempt success. That is failure. In the eyes of Allah, if you attempt, you have passed. This is the beauty of our religion. If you try, then you will pass. You might not pass with an A, you might pass with a B or a C. But nobody who tries, nobody who puts in an effort will fail. And this is the beauty of our Lord, the beauty of our faith, the beauty of our deen. O Muslim, do not judge yourself based upon the template of perfection. Because if you do so, you are setting yourself up for failure. You were not created to be perfect, don't you understand? You were not created to compete with the angels. You were created to show that despite your fallible nature, despite your sinful predisposition, you still choose to turn to Allah. And no matter how often you falter, no matter how often you fail in the process of achieving perfection, you never stop trying to achieve. You know you're not going to get there. You know you're not going to become an angel, but you still try and try and try. And in that trying is your Jannatul Firdaus. In that trying is your act to become an angel. You will never actually become one. But when you attempt to do so, Allah might even bless you more than He blesses the angels. Our scholars mention a part of our theology. There's a debate in classical Islam. You know, a lot of times our scholars have too much time, so they start debating things that are a little bit abstract. And one of the things they debated, who is better, a pious person or an angel? This is a debate in our Islamic theology. And the debate doesn't need to happen. We know from the Quran who is better. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اُسْجُدُوا لِآدَمِ. Allah said to the malaika, do sajda to Adam. فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ. All of the malaika showed reverence to Adam. Even though Adam was mortal. Adam was fallible. Adam was created of flesh and blood. Our scholars therefore mention, in reality, the pious human, Allah has shown that he is more worthy of respect than even the angels. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala demonstrated this even before Adam became a sinner, knowing Adam would become a sinner. That is the default of piety, the default of taqwa. So, O Muslim, as we begin these 10 nights, as we begin these 10 nights, tonight is the first of the 10 nights. We come to this masjid, every single one of us, with baggage that our closest friends, our children, our spouses don't even know. We come with a hidden closet of secrets, maybe even not closets, but bank vaults, mountains of sins. We come with that which, if our closest friends knew about us, they would no longer want to be friends with us. Every one of us, we have transgressed against the blessings Allah has given us. I am a sinner, and you are a sinner. We are all equal in this regard. And Shaitan comes, and Shaitan wants us to reach his level of despair and desperation. So Shaitan says, what's the point? And he'll remember and remind us of that secret bank vault. He's going to come and tell us of all of that hidden skeletons in our closet, because he knows. Why would he not know? He's accompanying us. He's the one enticing us. Half or the majority of the stuff in that closet, he's the one that whispered you to do. So he wants to drag you down there. But we need to remind ourselves, it doesn't matter how many skeletons are in that closet. It doesn't matter how much baggage is in there. What did our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? That Allah says, Hadith Qudsi, Yabna Adam, O son of Adam, O son of Adam, if you come to me with an earth full of sins, earth full. Who amongst us has an earth full of sins? If you come to me with an entire planet of sins, and then you ask my forgiveness, and you worship me without associating any partners, you say the kalima, la ilaha illallah, and you ask for my forgiveness, I shall come to you with an earth full of forgiveness. Allah doesn't care how large your sins are, how frequent your sins are, how massive your sins are. You are not dealing with me and you. You're not dealing with a mortal such that there's a finite quantity in the bank of Allah. No. Allah's khazana and Allah's rahmah cannot be counted. It is infinite. So when you approach the Almighty, when you approach the source of rahmah, He is Rahman, He is Rahim. When you approach the one who called himself Arhamur Rahimin, then realize it doesn't matter what is in your cabinet and closet. It doesn't matter the quantity of skeletons you have. It doesn't matter how heinous the crimes are. The goal is to attempt to live a better life. The goal is to try your best to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to ask Allah azza wa jal for forgiveness, and to make the attempt to be better. Because here's the point, in that attempt, we know deep down inside we're never going to be fully perfect. Now the goal is, by the way, the goal without a doubt is to eliminate as many sins as possible. There's no question about that. But we know we're never going to be sinless. If that is the case, then what is the redemption? What is the salvation? The salvation is never to give up hope in Allah's mercy, and to persistently, continuously put in good effort to counter the negatives. I gave the talk 2 days ago about the ayah in the Quran, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Good deeds absolve bad deeds. Al-Hasan al-Basri said, I know of nothing that is more effective in countering past sins than current good deeds. I repeat, I know of nothing that is better in dissolving your past sins than your current good deeds. So increase your good deeds and your past sins will be resolved. It's very simple, O Muslim. You turn to Allah. You make a sincere commitment to Allah. You make the intention in your heart. We are all battling with our internal demons. Every one of us. I repeat, every one of us. Don't ever think the person next to you is an angel. If we were angels, we wouldn't be sitting here. We might have different demons, no doubt about it. We might have different levels, no doubt about it. We might have different addictions, yes. But at core, we are all equally human. Is that not the case? We are all equally flesh and blood. So never think that you are the only sinner sitting in this masjid. I am a sinner and you are a sinner. We are all equally sinful in terms of us being humans. That we are all the same. Now that we've established that, the goal then, as I said, is not to become sinless. The goal is to come to Allah with a remorseful heart, a penitent heart. The goal is to acknowledge your sins, to admit you're human and fallible, to recognize there is no hope for me except through you, by you, with you, O Allah. That recognition is our salvation. And we learn it from our father Adam alayhi salam, when he committed the sin that he did. And subhanAllah, and again, I've said this so many times, even last year I gave the khatir the same thing I mentioned, because wallahi, it's an amazing story. The story of the Genesis, the story of Adam and Hawa. What Allah gave them, and still, Adam being me and you, Adam did what he did, right? What Allah, he literally gave them Jannah. He literally created them out of nothing and said to them, you and your wife, you and Hawa, go in Jannah and do whatever you want. Eat whatever you want, wear whatever you want, live wherever you want. Just one little garden and one little tree in that garden, that's it. But see, here's where the fallibility comes, right? That's the story of humanity. Adam is me and you because he is our father. We would have done the same, frankly, we would have done it before our father Adam. Adam made the mistake that he did. And he was sent down. But he recognized, قَالَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ Ya Rabb, I wronged myself. I did something I shouldn't have done. Own up, be responsible. Those addictions you're struggling with, the friendships that are haram, the people that are in your life that shouldn't be there, the dealings you do that are filthy, that are haram for your wealth. We all know, you know, between you and Allah, it shouldn't be there. Raise your hands and say, Ya Rabb, you know my sins. I don't need to hide you. There is nothing to hide from you. Ya Rabb, I come to you confessing my sins. Ya Rabb, with these sins, I come to you knowing no one can forgive other than you. You are the Ghafoor, you are the Ghaffar, you are the Tawwab. Ya Rabb, you promised us in the Quran that you forgive all sins. Ya Rabb, I believe the Quran, so I'm here right now asking you, Allah, forgive all of my sins, the first of the sins and the last of the sins, the major of the sins, the minor of the sins, the public of the sins, the private of the sins. Open your hands to Allah, open your hearts to Allah, beg and plead. And in that, dear Muslim, is your salvation. Not in becoming angels, not in becoming sinless. That's not going to happen. That's not why Allah created you. Don't you understand? You were created to manifest Allah's rahmah. And so desire that rahmah. Show Allah you want that rahmah. Show Allah you want to be forgiven. And if you do so sincerely, and a part of being sincere is you put in the effort. You have to try. You can't just continue to live your lifestyle of yesterday. Again, you're not going to be perfect. You and I are going to fall back to some of those same sins. But try. If you are a 5 out of 100, try to get to 10 and 15 out of 100, right? And as Ramadan comes, try to get higher and higher. You put in that effort. Just be better than you were yesterday. Oh Muslim, you're not competing with the prophets and the anbiya and the awliya. You're competing with yourself. You are your worst enemy. If you can beat yourself, you'll win. Simple as that. If you can be better today than you were yesterday, and you can be better tomorrow than you were today, you are a winner. You are in your own race. You're not competing with anybody else. So as you are here today in the first of the 10 nights, I ask myself and all of you, think about that which is holding you back between you and Allah. Think about what is dragging you down. And you know you don't want it. Wallahi, you and I know we don't like these things. They bring the stress and the grief and the filth. They make us feel impure. We don't want it, man. We really don't want it. Deep down inside, we know it's not good. And that's why we're here right now on Saturday night at 3:15 a.m. That's why we're here. Because we love feeling connected with our Lord. Because nothing feels sweeter than having that connection and ta'alluq of our qalb with our Rabb. There is no pleasure greater than the pleasure of Islam. There is no sweetness more sweet than the sweetness of Iman. There is no nobility more noble than the feeling of taqwa. And that's why we're here right now. We know this, that's why we're here. So make this commitment between you and Allah. You don't need any priests, any pundits, you don't have any holy men. That's the beauty of our religion. You and Allah, and you're competing against yourself. Make that commitment right here and now. I'm going to be a better person after this Ramadan. Starting from now, not tomorrow, not the next year, right now, I'm going to try my best. Think about your worst habits and make it a point. I'm going to start eliminating, cutting back as much as I can. Think about that which you need to do in your life, whether it's your salah, whether it's your siyam, and you make a commitment right here and now. I'm going to try my best to increase that. And again, if you falter, if you slip, if you fall, you know what? Dust off yourself, stand up again and try again. And if you fall again, stand up again. And if you fall again, stand up and fall and stand and fall and stand until you meet your Lord. Because it is in your attempt to stand. It is in your attempt to stand that you will gain your salvation. Even if you don't finish the race, O Muslim, even if you don't get to the very first, as long as you try and as long as you attempt, you shall pass. This is a guarantee. A guarantee from Allah. Allah never fails the one who tries, unlike any boss, any professor, any teacher. Allah never fails the one who tries. So my sincere message to myself and all of you, never lose hope. Never lose hope. Keep on striving. Keep on trying. No matter how guilty you are, no matter how big your sins are, Allah's mercy is infinitely larger than you. Allah's rahmah is infinitely vaster than you and your petty sins. So turn to Allah, cleanse your heart, be firm in your commitment. Even if your actions fail, your commitment should not fail. Your commitment must be up for the entirety of your life. Remember, if you fail in your actions, don't stop the commitment. The commitment has to be maintained. You keep on trying and trying and trying and never stop trying. Never give up hope. Because as I said, in that striving and in that attempt, this is what Allah wants. That's why Allah created you and me. To show the angels, despite the fact these sinners are here, look at how much they're trying. Despite the fact they're not perfect, they still are attempting to be perfect. And that is what the wisdom of our creation is. So, O Muslim, as we begin these nights, cleanse your heart of any sin and evil. Purify your intentions. Ask Allah's forgiveness tonight and every single night. Ask Allah for hidayah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to become better and religious. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the sirat al-mustaqim easy for you. That's why you say, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, over and over again, so many times a day. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow you to overcome your addictions, your problems, your troubles. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow you to fall in love with the sweetness of his religion, to fall in love with this, with the intoxication of iman, so that the intoxications of this dunya become nothing to you. Wallahi, O Muslim, wallahi, once you taste the intoxication of ibadah, the intoxication of worshipping Allah, there is no other intoxication in this dunya that will ever compete with that. And that's why the awliya and the muttaqoon, that's why the elite and the righteous people, they are not tempted the way me and you are tempted. It's not that they are automatically created holy. It's that in their struggle and in their attempt to become better, they've tasted a sweetness. They've tasted a reality that is more precious to them than the fake realities me and you live. That's the difference. It's not that they were created different. It's that in their struggles and in their attempts, they have reached a level. And guess what? And with this I conclude, you can also reach that level. You can also reach that level. Don't ever give up hope. What is a pious person other than a sinner who kept on trying and trying and trying? And every single pious person in history, every single muttaqi and wali, every single person who achieved that level, they had to begin right where you and I are. Never lose hope. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Put your trust in Allah. Ask Allah for forgiveness and hidayah. And insha'Allah ta'ala, in that will be your salvation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never causes to go to waste the one who does good while he is in a state of righteousness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq and the ikhlas to stand on Laylatul Qadr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to taste the sweetness of iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise our ranks, cause us to be of those whose Ramadan is accepted, whose fasting is accepted, of those who stand on Laylatul Qadr. Allahumma ja'alna fi hadha ash-shahri min al-fa'izin bi rahmatika arhamar rahimin wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Just before we start, usually many of us, you know what? Me too, I forgot. Or the alarms, please. Check your alarms. I have mine also. So the alarms are off, phones are off, please. Jazakum Allah khair.
صلاة القيام يا ثابكم الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا بطانة لا يألونكم خبالا ودوا ما عنتم قد بدت البغضاء من أفواههم وما تخفي صدورهم أكبر قد بينا لكم الآيات إن كنتم تعقلون قد بينا لكم الآيات إن كنتم تعقلون ها أنتم أولئك تحبونهم ولا يحبونكم وتؤمنون بالكتاب كله وإذا لقوكم قالوا آمنا وإذا خلوا عضوا عليكم الأنامل من الغيظ قل موتوا بغيظكم إن الله عليم بذات الصدور إن تمسسكم حسنة تسؤهم وإن تصبكم سيئة يفرحوا بها وإن تصبروا وتتقوا لا يضركم كيدهم شيئا وإن تصبروا وتتقوا لا يضركم كيدهم شيئا إن الله بما يعملون محيط وإذ غدوت من أهلك تبوئ المؤمنين مقاعد للقتال والله سميع عليم إذ هم الطائفتان منكم أن تفشلا والله وليهما وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون ولقد نصركم الله ببدر وأنتم أذلة فاتقوا الله لعلكم تشكرون إذ تقول للمؤمنين ألن يكفيكم أن يمدكم ربكم بثلاثة آلاف من الملائكة منزلين بلى إن تصبروا وتتقوا ويأتوكم من فورهم هذا يمددكم ربكم بخمسة آلاف من الملائكة مسومين وما جعله الله إلا بشرى لكم ولتطمئن قلوبكم به وما النصر إلا من عند الله العزيز الحكيم ليقطع طرفا من الذين كفروا أو يكبتهم فينقلبوا خائبين ليس لك من الأمر شيء أو يتوب عليهم أو يعذبهم فإنهم ظالمون ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله غفور رحيم ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله غفور رحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تأكلوا الربا أضعافا مضاعفة واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون واتقوا النار التي أعدت للكافرين وأطيعوا الله والرسول لعلكم ترحمون وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها نعم أجر العاملين قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فسيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين هذا بيان للناس وهدى وما وموعظة للمتقين ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين إن يمسسكم قرح فقد مس القوم قرح مثله وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس وليعلم الله الذين آمنوا ويتخذ منكم شهداء والله لا يحب الظالمين وليمحص الله الذين آمنوا ويمحق الكافرين أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يعلم الله الذين جاهدوا منكم ويعلم الصابرين ولقد كنتم تمنون الموت من قبل أن تلقوه وأنتم تنظرون فقد رأيتموه وأنتم تنظرون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل، أفإن مات أو قتلا انقلبتم على أعقابكم، ومن ينقلب على عقبيه فلن يضر الله شيئا، وسيجزي الله الشاكرين. وما كان لنفس أن تموت إلا بإذن الله كتابا مؤجلا، ومن يرد ثواب الدنيا نؤته منها، ومن يرد ثواب الآخرة نؤته منها، وسنجزي الشاكرين. وما كان لنفس أن تموت إلا بإذن الله كتابا مؤجلا، وما كان لنفس أن تموت إلا بإذن الله كتابا مؤجلا، ومن يرد ثواب الدنيا نؤته منها، ومن يرد ثواب الآخرة نؤته منها، وسنجزي الشاكرين. وكأي من نبي قاتل معه ربيون كثير، فما وهنوا لما أصابهم في سبيل الله وما ضعفوا وما استكانوا، والله يحب الصابرين. وما كان قولهم إلا أن قالوا ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا، ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. فآتاهم الله ثواب الدنيا وحسن ثواب الآخرة والله يحب المحسنين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تطيعوا الذين كفروا يردوكم على أعقابكم فتنقلبوا خاسرين. بل الله مولاكم وهو خير الناصرين. سنلقي في قلوب الذين كفروا الرعب بما أشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به عليكم سلطانا. سنلقي في قلوب الذين كفروا الرعب بما أشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا ومأواهم النار وبئس مثوى الظالمين. ولقد صدقكم الله وعده إذ تحسونهم بإذنه حتى إذا فشلتم وتنازعتم في الأمر وعصيتم من بعد ما أراكم ما تحبون. منكم من يريد الدنيا ومنكم من يريد الآخرة ثم صرفكم عنهم ليبتليكم ولقد عفا عنكم والله ذو فضل على المؤمنين. إذ تصعدون ولا تلوون على أحد والرسول يدعوكم في أخراكم فأثابكم غما بغم لكي لا تحزنوا على ما فاتكم ولا ما أصابكم والله خبير بما تعملون. ثم أنزل عليكم من بعد الغم أمنة نعاسا يغشى طائفة منكم وطائفة قد أهمتهم أنفسهم يظنون بالله غير الحق ظن الجاهلية يقولون هل لنا من الأمر من شيء قل إن الأمر كله لله يخفون في أنفسهم ما لا يبدون لك يقولون لو كان لنا من الأمر شيء ما قتلنا هاهنا قل لو كنتم في بيوتكم لبرز الذين كتب عليهم القتل إلى مضاجعهم وليبتلي الله ما في صدوركم وليمحص ما في قلوبكم والله عليم بذات الصدور. إن الذين تولوا منكم يوم التقى الجمعان إنما استزلهم الشيطان ببعض ما كسبوا ولقد عفى الله عنهم إن الله غفور حليم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين كفروا وقالوا لإخوانهم إذا ضربوا في الأرض أو كانوا غزا لو كانوا عندنا ما ماتوا وما قتلوا ليجعل الله ذلك حسرة في قلوبهم والله يحيي ويميت والله بما تعملون بصير. ولئن قتلتم في سبيل الله أو متتم لمغفرة من الله ورحمة خير مما يجمعون ولئن متتم أو قتلتم لإلى الله تحشرون فبما رحمة من الله لنت لهم ولو كنت فظا غليظ القلب لانفضوا من حولك فاعف عنهم واستغفر لهم وشاورهم في الأمر فإذا عزمت فتوكل على الله إن الله يحب المتوكلين ينصركم الله فلا غالب لكم وإن يخذلكم فمن ذا الذي ينصركم من بعده وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون وما كان لنبي أن يغل ومن يغلل يأت بما غل يوم القيامة ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون أفمن اتبع رضوان الله كمن باء بسخط من الله ومأواه جهنم وبئس المصير هم درجات عند الله والله بصير بما يعملون لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين
الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين.
والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم وممن حولكم من الأعراب منافقون ومن أهل المدينة مردوا على النفاق لا تعلمهم نحن نعلمهم سنعذبهم مرتين ثم يردون إلى عذاب عظيم وآخرون اعترفوا بذنوبهم خلطوا عملا صالحا وآخر سيئا عسى الله أن يتوب عليهم إن الله غفور رحيم خذ من أموالهم صدقة تطهرهم وتزكيهم بها وصل عليهم إن صلاتك سكن لهم والله سميع عليم ألم يعلموا أن الله هو يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويأخذ الصدقات وأن الله هو التواب الرحيم وقل اعملوا فسيرى الله عملكم ورسوله والمؤمنون وستردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون وآخرون مرجون لأمر الله إما يعذبهم وإما يتوب عليهم والله عليم حكيم والذين اتخذوا مسجدا ضرارا وكفرا وتفريقا بين المؤمنين وإرصادا لمن حارب الله ورسوله من قبل وليحلفن إن أردنا إلا الحسنى والله يشهد إنهم لكاذبون لا تقم فيه أبدا لمسجد أسس على التقوى من أول يوم أحق أن تقوم فيه فيه رجال يحبون أن يتطهروا والله يحب المطهرين أفمن أسس بنيانه على تقوى من الله ورضوان خير أم من أسس بنيانه على شفا جرف هار فانهار به في نار جهنم والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين لا يزال بنيانهم الذي بنوا ريبة في قلوبهم إلا أن تقطع قلوبهم والله عليم حكيم إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة يقاتلون في سبيل الله فيقتلون ويقتلون وعدا عليه حقا في التوراة والإنجيل والقرآن ومن أوفى بعهده من الله فاستبشروا ببيعكم الذي بايعتم به وذلك هو الفوز العظيم التائبون العابدون الحامدون السائحون الراكعون الساجدون الآمرون بالمعروف والناهون عن المنكر والحافظون لحدود الله وبشر المؤمنين ما كان للنبي والذين آمنوا أن يستغفروا للمشركين ولو كانوا أولي قربى من بعد ما تبين لهم أنهم أصحاب الجحيم. وما كان استغفار إبراهيم لأبيه إلا عن موعدة وعدها إياه فلما تبين له أنه عدو لله تبرأ منه إن إبراهيم لأواه حليم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. وما كان الله ليضل قوما بعد إذ هداهم حتى يبين لهم ما يتقون، إن الله بكل شيء عليم. إن الله له ملك السماوات والأرض يحيي ويميت، وما لكم من دون الله من ولي ولا نصير. لقد تاب الله على النبي والمهاجرين والأنصار الذين اتبعوه في ساعة العسرة من بعد ما كاد يزيغ قلوب فريق منهم ثم تاب عليهم إنه بهم رؤوف رحيم. وعلى الثلاثة الذين خلفوا حتى إذا ضاقت عليهم الأرض بما رحبت وضاقت عليهم أنفسهم وظنوا أن لا ملجأ من الله إلا إليه ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا إن الله هو التواب الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. ما كان لأهل المدينة ومن حولهم من الأعراب أن يتخلفوا عن رسول الله ولا يرغبوا بأنفسهم عن نفسه ذلك بأنهم لا يصيبهم ظمأ ولا نصب ولا مخمصة في سبيل الله ولا يطؤون موطئا يغيظ الكفار ولا ينالون من عدو نيلا إلا كتب لهم به عمل صالح إن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين. ولا ينفقون نفقة صغيرة ولا كبيرة ولا يقطعون واديا إلا كتب لهم ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما كانوا يعملون. وما كان المؤمنون لينفروا كافة فلولا نفر من كل فرقة منهم طائفة ليتفقهوا في الدين ولينذروا قومهم إذا رجعوا إليهم لعلهم يحذرون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا قاتلوا الذين يلونكم من الكفار وليجدوا فيكم غلظة واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين. وإذا ما أنزلت سورة فمنهم من يقول أيكم زادته هذه إيمانا فأما الذين آمنوا فزادتهم إيمانا وهم يستبشرون. وأما الذين في قلوبهم مرض فزادتهم رجسا إلى رجسهم وماتوا وهم كافرون. أولا يرون أنهم يفتنون في كل عام مرة أو مرتين ثم لا يتوبون ولا هم يذكرون. وإذا ما أنزلت سورة نظر بعضهم إلى بعض هل يراكم من أحد ثم انصرفوا صرف الله قلوبهم بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. ربنا ولك الحمد. طيب. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Salatul Witr. I pray three rak'ah, one tashahhud. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. وقالوا الحمد لله الحمد لله
الله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك تباركت ربنا وتعاليت فلك الحمد على ما قضيت اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أذل الشرك والمشركين وأذل الكفر والكافرين اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة اللهم انصرهم نصرا عزيزا اللهم أفرغ عليهم صبرا وثبت أقدامهم وانصرهم على القوم الكافرين اللهم تقبل شهداءهم وداوي جرحاهم واشف مرضاهم واشف مرضاهم وأطعم جائعهم يا كريم يا كريم يا أكرم الأكرمين أكرمهم بكرمك يا رب العالمين اللهم يا قوي يا عزيز أرنا في بني صهيون يوما أسودا كيوم عاد وثمود اللهم زلزل الأرض تحت أقدامهم وألق الرعب في قلوبهم اللهم أحصهم عددا ولا تذر منهم أحدا اللهم دمرهم تدميرا اللهم دمرهم تدميرا اللهم لا ترفع لهم راية ولا تحقق لهم غاية اللهم اجعلهم لمن بعدهم آية يا قوي يا عزيز إنهم لا يعجزونك أرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك يا قوي يا منتقم يا رب العالمين اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم يا مقلب القلوب يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك ثبت قلوب أولادنا على دينك اللهم حبب الصلاة إلى أولادنا وحبب الحجاب إلى نسائنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر لوالدينا اللهم اغفر لآبائنا واغفر لأمهاتنا وارزقهم الفردوس الأعلى يا كريم يا عزيز يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا كريم يا رب العالمين يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث، أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر، اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر، اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار، اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار، وأعتق رقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا من النار. يا كريم يا غفار يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أغث إخواننا في اليمن وفي سوريا وفي لبنان وفي أفغانستان وفي السودان وفي باكستان وفي بنغلاديش وفي الهند وفي بورما. يا رب أنقذهم يا مغيث يا مغيث، أغث المستضعفين في كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين. يا رب العالمين، لا تتوفانا إلا وأنت راض عنا، اللهم ارض عنا، اللهم ارض عنا وارض عن آبائنا وارض عن أمهاتنا. اللهم ارزق أبناءنا الزوجات الصالحات وارزق بناتنا الأزواج الصالحين يا أكرم الأكرمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. سبحان الملك القدوس، سبحان الملك القدوس، سبحان الملك القدوس.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.